State leading 36-19 over Grand Canyon at halftime. Time now for our First Interstate Bank scoreboard update. Some finals from around the conference. Northern Colorado was at number 3 Houston, and they got smoked 83-36. Northern Arizona over in East Lansing falls to Michigan State 73-55. Idaho just barely edged on the road at Denver. They lose 68-63. Idaho State in a tough matchup with Brigham Young University right now. Idaho State trailing 31-30 early in the second half. Coming up a little bit later, Eastern Washington will be at Santa Clara. Washington hosts Weber State, so Weber State get a tough matchup. And then Sacramento State is at number 8 UCLA later tonight at 9:30. So some really good matchups from around the conference. We'll take a break and come back to our First Interstate Bank broadcast position after this timeout and get the second half underway. Montana State leading Grand Canyon 36-19. This is Bobcat Basketball from Learfield. Bobcat Basketball is brought to you by Kendall Ford Lincoln of Bozeman, a proud supporter of Montana State Athletics. We're big fans of teamwork, dedication, and helping customers find the best deal on the perfect vehicle to fit their needs. Get started at KendallFordBozeman.com. Kendall, let's start something great. Montana State leading 36-19 as we get set for the second half of action for the Cats on the road at Grand Canyon University, a top 100 team around the country and a place that sells out almost every game. You can hear this place is rocking and rolling all day. We remind you that all the Bobcats timeouts are presented by Prime Lending, home loans made simple. Cats in that first half went on a long 15-0 run early. And they've been able to maintain a double-digit lead throughout the first half, and they push it out to a 17-point lead to begin the second half after a Tyler Patterson three-point knockdown. Montana State with the basketball. We flip sides. Cats going from left to right in the road navy blue uniforms with the gold font. Here's Brown on the drive to the elbow. Kicks it back out to Battle at the top. Works his way to the left elbow and has to take it back out beyond the arc. Looking for Bello in the post. Bounce pass down to the left block. Bello back to the basket. Back and down. Spins. Has it knocked away. Recovered. Kicks it out. It is recovered by MSU with 7 seconds to shoot. Brown at the top five. Brown with a dribble four. Around the to the elbow. Bounce to Bello. Gets the rack and jams it home with two hands at the end of the shot clock on the dime by Brown. My goodness, what a slam right as the shot clock expired. Basketball held by Grand Canyon. Montana State up 38-19, their largest lead of the day. Down to the left block. Swarm, Lekalat with a defense. Layup is good. Tough finish that time by McLaughlin. Montana State leading 38-21 with 1 minute away in the second half. Brown at the top. Takes it to the left elbow. Kicks it back out to the top of the key. Now to the right wing, Patterson. Bounce to Lekalat in the post, right side of the baseline. Back it down with the dribble on the left hand. Puts it in his mitts. Bounce pass out to the left corner. Montana State with two to shoot. Brown at half court, one. Tries it from the logo. That's no good. Off the heel of the iron. And Lekalat with a rebound as he gets undercut. Should be a foul on Grand Canyon. We'll double check here. But Lekalat got undercut as he went for that rebound. Came down hard. And the foul is on Gabe McLaughlin. Good hustle by Lekalat at the end of that shot clock. I think they're going to review the shot clock here. I think they got to make sure that they did get that shot off. It was a logo shot by Brown. The officials are going to come together here and discuss things. So we're not 100% sure, but what I believe is happening here is that they are trying to figure out if that shot got off before the shot clock expired. And they are going into the monitor here. They did not take a media timeout. Everybody's still standing on their feet. So we are staying here as they go to the monitor. And we presume that they are making sure that Brown got that shot off before the shot clock expired. It was a pretty good look. So they've got a big purple GCU at center court, and it stretches pretty far. It's only maybe 4 or 5 feet from the top of the three-point line, and he was on the outside of the U, and that shot had some legs to it. It was actually a little strong. It bounced off the heel of the iron, and credit Sam Lekalat for getting up there and ripping that thing down and then drawing the foul. And that's where it is right now, but they are taking a look at the monitor, and we'll see what this call becomes. For Montana State, they have a grueling opening portion of their schedule here. They've got not one, but two Pac-12 teams on the schedule. Next week at Long Beach State on a Sunday for a 5 p.m. tip. Then later that week out at Oregon on a Tuesday night. Their only home game of the month of November is on November 18th, hosting Warner Pacific. That's the eve of the Cat Grizz football game, which for the football squad could be a game potentially that could line up a Big Sky Conference championship. Then at North Dakota the day after that Cat Grizz game, and then out to Montreal for three games for a Thanksgiving tournament against UNC Greensboro, Quinnipiac, and Middle Tennessee. And then they finish up November at Southern Utah. They're actually going to travel from Montreal to Southern Utah, so it's going to be a long Thanksgiving road trip for the guys. And we'll see. We're going to know a lot about this team at the end of November. And Montana State trying to follow up a championship season here and get this year off with a 1-0 start. But it's not going to be easy against this very skilled Grand Canyon team with two teams that were both picked first in the preseason polls. The Bobcats need your support to go for the win. Donate to the Bobcat Club's Free to Win campaign to reach our $3 million goal supporting student athletes. Okay, it looks like that shot got off. What do we got? It's holding up two. So is Grand Canyon shooting free throws? Or they show it saying that was a foul on Grand Canyon. We don't have an explanation yet. They're giving this ball to Grand Canyon. Are they saying this was a shot clock violation, or is it Montana State basketball? They initially called a foul. Whose ball is it? Officials don't even seem to know right now. I think the official. So what initially happened? They confirmed the call. The official miscommunicated. He held up two hands as if he was giving two shots to Grand Canyon. That's not the case. And it is a foul on Grand Canyon, and it is Montana State basketball. Inbound to Lekalat. Up to the top of the key. Hands off to Tyler Patterson on the left side. Into battle over in the left corner. With the dribble beyond the arc. Bounce bounce into the post, Leckel at left baseline. 10 to shoot, back to the basket, with the dribble, back and down, hops into the lane, kicks to the right corner. Patterson, catch and shoot three. That's no good, and the rebound corralled by Grand Canyon. Blackshirt to the top, out to the right wing, open three ball. No good, too strong. Diving for the loose ball, out of bounds, staying with Grand Canyon, but great hustle by Tyler Patterson going after that loose ball. Diving down on the hardwood. Guys have brought the energy. Certainly not coaching effort today. 38-21, Montana State on top, 18:06 to go in the second half, and the inbound pass is stolen. Brown in transition, going to the rack, hands off to Battle, the two-hand slam! Brown the steal and the dime to Battle, who rattles the rim, giving the catch a 40-21 lead with 17:50 to go in the second. Boy, a tomahawk dunk. Put that ball behind his head before he brought it home. And on the other side, Isaiah Shaw responds with a three ball. 40-24, Montana State on top. 17:30 to go in the second half. Lekulat up at the top. Hands off for Battle, curls to the free throw line, pulls up, got blocked. Ooh, no call. And the ball corralled by Grand Canyon. I thought it got hit on the forearm, no call. Lopes with the basketball. Blackshirt down to the mid post, goes to the rim, lays it up, no good. Offensive board, the putback is in by Otrago. Bello affected that initial shot, but they got the offensive putback. And now it's a 14-point game, Montana State on top. They've led by as many as 19, but you can feel the sense of urgency from Grand Canyon. Bello to the cup, had it stripped, and he's fouled. Ooh, Danny Sprinkles getting hot here. Up into the official's ears, giving him the hand to cool it down a little bit. And now he's going to get a calm explanation nice job by the official to let him say his piece. Give him an explanation in a calm tone, trying to diffuse the situation. You like to see when an official doesn't escalate there. Coaches are going to be hot, but can the officials come back and calmly explain something and then move on? Bello at the free throw line. His first is good. How about the dance team? They've got a nice little trick here. So they're right behind the basket. They've all got their silver pom-poms, and then they kind of wave them up and down like a wave in a snake. So the dancer on the left side raises her hands up first, and then everybody fouls, and it turns into kind of a silver pom-pom wave. Looks good. That's pretty distracting. Bello focused through the rec specs, looking at the rim, bends to the knees, puts it up with the right hand, and the shot is good. Bello knocks them both down, 4 points in the second half for Bello. 7 overall today in his first game of the year. Montana State back up 42-26, 17 minutes remaining. Up at the top, Harrison has the dribble. Preseason All-Conference. Chest pass over to Blackshirt, preseason player of the year. Up to the top, into the right corner. Dribbles out to the top, tip free, recovered by Grand Canyon with 6 to shoot. Blackshirt at the left wing, tries the 3, that's no good, and Brown high points the rebound. Cats with the basketball up 42-26, 16:29 to go in the game. Brown slows it down, standing near the half court line, holding the ball chest high. Raises his right hand in the air to make the play call. Dribbles out to the left wing as he's pressured. Comes back out to the top and gives to Lekulat at the top of the key. Has it on the right wing. Bounce pass into the post. Here's Bello on the right baseline. Skip pass into the left corner. Out to the left wing Battle. Then to Brown. Thought about the 3. Pump fake. Now lets it fly. That's no good. Rebound tipped and a foul. Bello coming over the back. And he's charged with his second foul of the day. 16 minutes to go in the ball game. Montana State up 42-26. And I guess you could call this an upset if the Cats were to win, but it's hard to say that totally. You know, Grand Canyon was 92 in the net ranking at the end of last year. Montana State was in the low hundreds. Blackshirt, bounce pass down to the post on the left side, back and down, spins, no space, Leckel at the defense, puts it up with a righty hook shot, that short, and the rebound tipped and controlled by Grand Canyon. Could have been a 3-second call. Now we do have a whistle. What do we got? I think the shot clock didn't reset correctly. Boy, they let a lot of body contact go down underneath there. Join Champs New Kids Club, presented by Billings Clinic Bozeman. Your $25 membership fee gets you game tickets, Bobcat gear, and more. Sign up today at MSUBobcats.com, champs/Champs Kids Club. We'll take our first break of the second half. Montana State stretching out there, or trying to stretch out their lead. They're up 42-26 with 15:34 to go in the ball game. Back to our First Interstate Bank broadcast position after this. This is Bobcat Basketball from Learfield.
And now fans, give it up for your GC.
.34 to go in the ball game. Montana State up on the road, leading 42-26 over Grand Canyon. Know what's below? Tap, click, or call 811 before you dig. Brought to you by Montana811.org. It is Grand Canyon basketball, and they will inbound from underneath their own hoop. Blackshirt lobs out toward the right wing to set it up. Harrison has the dribble. Down to the right elbow, backs it out again, throws to Blackshirt at the top. Around to the left wing, here's McMillan. Looking for the post, doesn't have it in the corner, seven to shoot. McMillan out to the left wing, five, gets to the elbow, kicks to the corner, three, two, one. Hand off to McMillan, contested, three, air balled the Cats. Grab the rebound, push ahead to battle on the right wing. One on one, going to the rack, had it stripped, loose. Cats recover, Osabor draws the foul. Great hustle by Montana State, and great hustle by great Osabor to get over there as well. Third foul on Chance McMillan. Boy, great defense by Montana State. They have held Grand Canyon to 28% from the field today. Cats have had a complete effort offensively. Battle leading the way with eight. Osabor with seven. Bello with seven today. Michael Ladd bounces it up to Battle at the top of the key. Throws over to the right wing for four. Give it to Osabor, left elbow. One dribble, hands off to Battle, curls into the lane, gets into the middle of the paint, floats it up. That's no good, missed it right. Contested shot, Grand Canyon clears the rebound, and they move from right to left. Here's Harrison with a bounce. Into the lane, going to the cup, lefty layup off the glass. No good, Battle the defense, and it's tipped out of bounds, going to the Cats. And the baseline official made the call, giving Montana State the basketball. And now the right wing official just came in and overruled him. He's saying that's my call, even though the baseline official was a little bit closer. Danny Sprinkle hoping for a replay. Not going to get it. Big turn of events there. Grand Canyon with the basketball, trailing 42-26, 14:44 to go in the ballgame. Passed out to the right wing. Harrison lobs into the post on the right side. McLaughlin puts it on the deck, working on Osabor. Spins into the lane, lefty hook, rimming, good. That's a tough finish by Gabe McLaughlin. 4 points in the second half. He's got nine total today. Montana State with the ball up 42-28. 14:20 to go in the game. Toss to the right wing for Robert Ford. Looking for the post, finds Osabor with a jump pass on the right block. Puts it on the deck with one dribble, spins, fall away righty, hook, no! Ooh, fell right off the front end of the rim. And Grand Canyon grabs the rebound. Now the Cats offense starting to slow down a little bit. Kicked out to the top, Bauman for three, that's good! That'll bring the house down. 6 points for Bauman. Montana State up 42-31. Timeout called by the Cats. Good time to take the timeout. Cats still up by 11, but their lead cut from 19. That'll take us to a break as well. 13:50 to go in the game. Montana State leading 42-31. This is Bobcat Basketball from Learfield.
Or at GCU Men's Basketball on Facebook for highlights, behind-the-scenes content, news stories, and more. And now, fans, give it up for the GCU Cheerleaders, GCU Dancers, and the Thundering Herd Met Band. Montana's Ribbon Chop House has been serving Rocky Mountain communities for over 20 years. Our ability to grow has come through our commitment to Rocky Mountain hospitality, a concept which incorporates a casual attitude with our commitment to loyalty, safety, service, and quality food. We hope you'll be our guest at one of our Montana locations soon. Montana State, one of their last seven from the field as we return to our first Interstate Bank broadcast position. Cats using a Prime Lending timeout. Prime Lending, home loans made simple. Montana State is led by as many as 19. Their lead cut to 11. They have the basketball to our right, trying to get out of an offensive funk. Out to the right wing for Ford on the right side. Beyond the arc, bounce into the post for Fuller. Holding the ball above his head. Facing up, backs it out a bit with a dribble. Gives it to Osibor on that side. His pass was tipped. It is loose. And they're calling a foul on great Osibor. And Danny Sprinkle with a big punch through the sky on that 50-50 ball. He didn't like the call. Second foul on Osibor. And the Cats are giving it back. And now this is a titanic possession for Grand Canyon. This near sellout crowd is starting to get back into it. Grand Canyon has an opportunity to make this a single-digit game after they trailed by 19. Blackshire out to the right wing. Thrown into the right corner. Harrison has the dribble. On the drive. Going to the cup. Lays it up. Good and one. Brown picks up the foul. His third. And they'll be going to the line trying to complete a three-point play. Serving all your garage door needs, DoorTech is raising the door on quality. It's a nine-point game, chance to make it eight. At this point for the Cats, if they were to give up a lead, they'd really feel like they gave it away. At some point, this offense is going to come back, but they're one of their last seven. This free throw slices through the silence, and it is good. Completes the three-point play. 4 points for Rayshon Harrison. 42-34. Montana State on top. 13:21 to go in the ballgame, but they're on their heels here as Grand Canyon's on an 8-0 run. Crowd starting to come alive and make some noise now out of the left wing. Taken up to the top by Ford on the drive. Stops mid-post. Kicks out to the right wing, McMahon. Takes it around to the top of the key. Into the right corner, Ford. The defensive intensity ramping up for Grand Canyon. Down into the post right side for Fuller. Back to the basket. Seven to shoot. We've got a whistle and a three-second lane violation. Not a lane violation, but it said a foul on Rayshon Harrison, his third. Correct, yes, foul on Harrison. Montana State puts 20 seconds on the shot clock. Danny Sprinkle working the officials just in front of us. And here's Ford to inbound to the baseline. Lobs it out to the right wing for Fuller and sets it up. Hands off back to Brown. Excuse me, Ford rather. Dribbling up at the top on the U. Over to the left wing. On the left sideline. Now crosses over into the lane, going to the rack, the finger roll, no, put back good. Great Osamor putting it in. He's got 9, and the Cats break their slump. They had been 1 of their last 7, and it was the put back by Great Osamor. Cats back up by 10. 12:35 to go in the game. Blackshire out on the right wing. Kicks up the top. McLaughlin thought about a 3. Now drives down to the left block. Floater up. Good off the window. What a finish by McLaughlin into double figures with 11. That was some great defense by Osabor, and he just raised a little bit higher to kiss it off the glass. Montana State up 44-36. 12:15 to go in the game. We got a ball game on the road for Montana State in the season opener. McMahon bounced to Osabor at the top. Bounce pass into the lane, tip free and stolen. A turnover by Montana State. Grand Canyon with the basketball. They're down 8. The drive, Bauman lays it up. That's good. High off the window. And we got a 6-point game. Grand Canyon has the ball rolling downhill now with 11:45 to go in the contest. Montana State led by 19. Battle out of the right wing. Double team given to Osamor on the elbow. His pass to the corner, tipped, recovered by Ford. 10 seconds to shoot. McMahon has it at the top, pulls up at the elbow. The jumper, short, rebound, Grand Canyon. Lopes from right to left. Try to draw as close as they've been since early in the first half, and a foul on the swipe. Who's it gonna be? Two guys were there. Either Battle or Osabor. And it's given to Raekwon Battle, his 3rd, and that'll take us to a break. Cats on their heels. Their 19-point lead has been cut to 6. Montana State 44, Grand Canyon 38, 11:22 to go in the ballgame. Back to the First Interstate State Bank broadcast position after this. This is Bobcat Basketball from Learfield. Hype as can be on the road. Montana State on their heels, but leading 44-38 with 11:22 to go in the ballgame. Back in our First Interstate Bank broadcast position, courtside in Phoenix. Montana State led by 19, but Grand Canyon on a 12-2 run. They've knocked down each of their last 5 shots, and this near sellout crowd has come back to life. Grand Canyon basketball, inbounds pass underneath. And the layup is no good. Montana State grabs the rebound. They get a much-needed stop. Cats with the basketball into the front court, slowing it down a bit. Round up to the top around the screen. Give it to Patterson. Into the right corner, here's Ford. Toss up the top for Brown with the dribble. Moves left around the screen to the wing. Into the mid-post, kicks out to the top. Here's Ford. Crossover, step back, 2 ball on the elbow. No good. Bellow the rebound, had a tip free and a foul. McMillan came flying in and definitely got him on the arm. Crowd's not going to like it, but an easy call. That's the 4th foul on Chance McMillan now. 44-38, Montana State on top, 10:52 to go. Cats had a 19-point lead, and Grand Canyon has drawn back to within 6 here, but sometimes when you see a team battle back like this, they kind of you know, use all that momentum and energy to get back, and then they start to peter out a little bit. Cats are going to get this offense going again soon. They're one of their last eight. Here's Bello, mid-range J. That's no good, missed it right. And he's sprinkle rolling his eyes walking away from the bench. And Montana State is one of their last nine from the field. Grand Canyon with the ball. Trying to make this potentially a one-point game, they're down by six, but they could make it a one-possession game. Instead, they go for the two, and they got it. Drago floating it home. Four-point game. Montana State up 44-40. Montana State's been outscored 21-8 in the second half. 10-10 to go in the game. Brown on the drive, puts up the runner off the glass, rims out, and Montana State is one of their last 10 from the field. McMillian in transition, bounce pass stolen. Caleb Fuller got it, and Brown was there to help tip it away. Cats get a huge turnover, and let's see if they can get this offense back on track. Out of the right elbow, here's Bello. Cats up 4, 9:45 to go in the game. Gets rid of it with a lob out near the half-court line for Brown. Then given to Ford on the right wing. Eight to shoot. Ford spins into the lane. Stops the free throw line. Fall away. Jay caught it to go. Swirls home. Robert Ford, his first bucket, and it ends the drought, bringing the rain. And now he's ready to go, looking like a man possessed on defense. Montana State back up by six. 9 1/4 to go in this ballgame. Out to the left wing. McMillan has it beyond the arc, takes it to the top of the key, crosses over to the elbow, and lobs it back out beyond the arc for the point guard, Blackshire. To Harrison, back to Blackshire, 7 to shoot, curls into the lane, to the rack, lays it up and in. Broken play defensively for Montana State. First points for Blackshire in the second half. He's got 8 today. Cats up 46-42, 8:50 to go in the ballgame. They're in a dogfight in the desert. Ford at the half-court line. Works his way over the left wing. Fires into the corner. Tyler Patterson misses the three ball. Rebound tip. Oh, and they called the foul. A light little touch by Brown on the lower back of the rebounder. Fourth foul on Darius Brown. Huge call. 46-42. Montana State on top. 8:41 to go in the ballgame. Montana State 0-4 from downtown in the second half. 25% from the field. Meanwhile, Grand Canyon shooting 59% from the field in the second half, 10 of 17. They've hit 7 of their last 8. Grand Canyon with a basketball. Blackshire into the front court, hands it off over on the right wing. Up to Harrison at the top of the key. Crosses over to the free throw line, picks up the dribble, and he got pulled down. Raekwon Battle got him. That's a foul, and Battle picks up his fourth. At Montana's Rib and Chop House, our staff is dedicated to creating extraordinary experiences that raise the bar in each of our communities. Enjoy premium steaks, fresh seafood, and award-winning baby back ribs. We look forward to sharing a little Rocky Mountain hospitality with you. Cats slipping into a little bit of foul trouble. Montana State's offense, after shooting over 50% in the first half, quieting here in the second. They shot 56% in the first 20 minutes, 25% in the second. 8:28 to go in the ballgame. Cats have not given up the lead yet. They led by as many as 19. They're up by 4. Baker over to the right wing. Going back to the top of the key. Ball wrapped around to the left wing. Only 7 to shoot. Here's the drive to the cup. The layup is good. Rayshon Harrison put it home. He's got 6. It's a one-possession game. Montana State was up 19 at half, and now it's 46-44. Montana State with the basketball. 8 minutes to go in the contest. McMahon comes around a screen at the top. Gives it over to the right wing. Ford comes around a screen down to the baseline. We've got a whistle. They called a foul on Grand Canyon. Noah Bauman picks up his third, and that will take us to a break. What a swing in this ball game. Montana State trying to avoid giving this thing away. They're up 46-44 with 7:53 to go in the contest. We'll take a break, coming back to our first Interstate Bank broadcast position. This is Bobcat Basketball from Learfield. milk is a nutrient-rich product. It contains 13 essential nutrients from vitamin A to zinc, all of which are important for a healthy immune system and overall wellness. That's 13 nutrients with seemingly endless benefits. Reach for milk and make every sip count. 7:53 to go in the ball game. Montana State up 46-44. They've nearly relinquished a 19-point lead from early in this half. Inbounds pass by Montana State. Osibor kicks it out to the right corner for Ford. The Cats set it up. Ford on the right wing. Cats have two big men in front. Out to the left corner, Patterson. Throws out to the top, McMahon. Comes right around a screen to the elbow. Going to the rack, righty layup off the glass. No good. Bello got the offensive rebound. One dribble back up, and he draws the foul. Jabril Bello, a key offensive rebound, and he's going to the line as Odrago picks up his second foul. Now Montana State needs to hit some free throws here. Only 7 of 13 from the stripe. Neither team has shot particularly well from the free throw line. Jabril Bello last season was sent. He'll line it up. Band in their candy stripe, purple and white overalls, jumping up and down behind the clear backboard. The free throw is good. Jabril Bello up to 8 points today. Again, this is tough. You know, Montana State, again, 19-point lead, but they haven't given it up, even though they've been punched in the gut in this second half. 7:36 left in the contest. This free throw is up and good. Got them both to go. 9 points for Jabril Bello in the season debut. Montana State back up 48-44. Grand Canyon's been as close as two. Out to the top. Drago around to the left wing. Harrison gives to the top of the key. Driving a kick. Driving in, turning in a hook, and that's good. By Odrago. He's got 6 points all in the second half. One of the lopes lost his shoe. Josh Baker just slides it right back on quickly. Montana State up two. 7 minutes to go in the game. Whistle, foul underneath on Grand Canyon. Noah Bauman, his fourth, as he was battling in the post with great Osibor. And Montana State will get some free throws here. Oh, man, this game, what a night. I mean, this is as difficult as it gets in terms of the atmosphere here. We've got three sections of students. You can imagine the energy they've brought, and that's not including the band, which is behind the basket, which great Osibor is facing now. Osibor last year, 66% from the free throw line. He's got 9 points this evening in the season opener. Trying to make this a two-possession game. The front end of the 1-1 is no good. Montana State 9 of 16 from the free throw line now. Grand Canyon with the ball to our left. Takes it up the top, throws to Blackshirt, drives from the wing, gets the rack, lays it up. That is good. Boy, a lot of contact, no call. Cats catch a break. Montana State has this game tied now at 48. Ford into the lane, gets rid of it out to the top. Osibor hands it off on the left wing. Here's McMahon. Bounce into the post, Osibor left side. Back it down, into the lane, spins, hooks, got it. Great Osibor putting it in off the glass. Cats back in front right after Grand Canyon had taken the lead, had tied the game for the first time since they had trailed by 19. 50-48, Montana State on top, 6:20 left. Blackshirt weaves out of the lane down to the right baseline, pump fake, kisses it up off the window. Devon Blackshirt getting going. The WAC preseason player of the year, showing you why. This game tied at 50. 6:10 to go in the contest. Ford across the half court line. Slinks to McMahon on the left wing. With a lefty dribble, picks it up, gives it with a bounce to Bello. He weaves over to the right wing. Between the leg dribble to the elbow. Gives it down to Osibor underneath on the right block with 10 to shoot. Osibor back and down, into the lane. Lefty hook, that's up, no good. Bello, the offensive rebound on the right block. Back up with a lefty hook, no. Osibor called for the over and back. Foul on Osibor, his third. They had two chances, couldn't get it to go. Grand Canyon has a chance to take their first lead since we were 2 minutes into this game. Third foul on Osibor. Man, what a ball game here. 50 points apiece. And Grand Canyon going to the line here for the front end of a 1-1. It's a tough foul. That over the back brings Grand Canyon all the way back down the floor. And Again, they're shooting the 1-1. The front end is no good, and Montana State grabs the rebound, so they still haven't given up the lead. But this game is tied at 50. We've had a pair of ties at 48 and 50. 5:35 to go in the ball game. Hand off at the top for Patterson. Open, top side three. That's no good. And the rebound collected by Grand Canyon. Cats are 0-5 from downtown in the second half. Out at the top of the key. Harrison throws over to the right wing. Baker curls around a screen, gets in the lane, bounce pass down to the right block. Back and down, kick back out to the right wing. Blackshear on the drive with a lefty bounce into the lane, swatted, block, oh, and a foul. I think it was on the initial defender on the floor. It was. That was Robert Ford who had the initial defense. He's called for the foul. The block up top by McMahon was not what was called. So Brown's got four. Ford's got three fouls, and Battle has four. Osabor also has three fouls. Blackshear to the line. This game tied at 50. Grand Canyon with a chance to take the lead for the first time since 2 minutes in, and they do. Blackshear with 13 points. Montana State led by 19 in the first 2 minutes of the second half. They've been outscored 32-14 in the second half. Blackshear at the line, bends to the knees, puts the shot up. That is no good, rims out. Cats have the ball down, 51-50. First time we've said that since Grand Canyon opened the game on a 4-0 run. Cats came back with a 15-0 run. They've led until now. This ball tipped free loose, but the Cats recover, and they get it up to the top for Bello. Hand off to McMahon, curls around a screen, going to the rack, puts it up off the glass, and got it to go. Big man bucket on the take by the sophomore Patrick McMahon. He's got four. Montana State back in front, 52-51. 4:45 to go. Montana State trying to win in the most hostile of territories. Harrison bounces it up to the top. Blackshear sets it up. Works his way over the left wing with 4:30 to go in the game. 10 to shoot. Blackshear, topside, three, no. Rebound, one. Patrick McMillan, a tough board, fighting for the loose ball. He wins the 50-50 ball. Oh, and they called a jump ball. No, 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 no. Harrison never had full command of it. McMahon had it and got rid of it, and they blew the whistle as McMahon was getting it off to his teammate. And the possession arrow gives the ball back to Grand Canyon. And they're going to put 20 seconds on the shot clock. Yikes.
Timeout call by Lutz.
Timeout by Grand Canyon. We'll keep it here. Wow. That is a big call. Really looked like Patrick McMahon had it. And as he was getting rid of it to one of his teammates, the official out of the right wing was the one who made the jump ball call. I don't know about that. The Bobcats need your support to go for the win. Donate to the Bobcat Club's 3-to-win campaign to reach our $3 million goal supporting student athletes. Montana State has the lead of 52-51 with 4:25 to go in the ball game. And they did actually take the timeout on the floor, so we'll take a break as well. This is Bobcat Basketball from Learfield. Grand Canyon to inbound, trailing 52-51 with 4:25 left in the ball game. Lopes have the ball to our left. Blackshire has it up at the top on above the purple G of GCU at midcourt. Give it up to the top, back to Blackshire. He's beyond the arc, seven to shoot. Hands off on the right wing, five on the drive by Baker. Four, blocked! Tyler Patterson had the block, Cats have the rebound, and Montana State up one with 4 minutes to go. Trying to win what would be a really quality victory on the road. Ford out at the top, giving over to the right wing, Patterson, looking for Osabor in the post, fires it inside, Osabor on the right block, backs into the lane, puts up the lefty hook, no good off the inside of the iron. Good look, it's what he wanted. Just a little too strong, didn't quite have the touch. Grand Canyon looking to retake the lead, down 52-51, 3:35. Drive from the right wing, laying it up, that's good. What a finish by Rayshon Harrison. 8 points for the transfer for Presbyterian in his Grand Canyon debut. Montana State down 53-52. Couple of the guys in foul trouble will check back in at the next whistle with 3:20 left. Ford out to Lekalat. Bounce pass down to the left block for McMahon. Backing it into the post. Turns around with a hook. That is no good. Missed it left. Danny Sprinkle wanted a call right up in the official's ear. A step or two onto the hardwood. Grand Canyon now trying to extend a 1 point lead. On the drive, that is blocked. Great. Osabor had it. Here comes Montana State. Ford into the front court. Weaves out to the top. And an illegal screen on Great Osabor, his fourth. And Danny Sprinkle is livid, and pulled back by his assistants. Cats getting tested early. We're going to find out what they're made of. Some of the Lopes hoping for a tee up on Danny Sprinkle. He's going to take it right to the edge, but in a game like this, you cannot get called for the tee. Montana State down 53-52. A 19-point lead has been evaporated in the second half. Outscored 34-16 in the second half. Grand Canyon with the ball. They've got it up at the top. McMillan with the bounce. Slings it over to the right wing, McLaughlin. Back up to the top. Around to the left wing for Harrison. Toss up to the top, Blackshire. Grand Canyon taking their time. Blackshire comes around to screen. Kicks back up to the top for Harrison. Into the left corner. McLaughlin on the drive. And the right-handed jam. Wow, what a finish by McLaughlin. Montana State down 55-52. 2:27 to go in the ballgame. Ford on the right wing, comes left around the screen to the top. Pulls up for the tying three. That is short. Rebound tip. Loose. Going out of bounds. Diving save, and it's out of bounds. No, it's staying with Montana State. It went out of bounds first before Ford got it. Officials are discussing it now. Ford tried to save it, and the officials are talking about it on the baseline. So it was tip 50-50. The officials are saying that it hit the baseline first before Ford got to it, and a great effort and hustle by Ford, and they give the ball to Grand Canyon on the discussion. They reverse the call again. Cats have had about three of those go against them. But that's no excuse for giving up a 19-point lead. Grand Canyon 55, Montana State 52. 2:17 to go in the game. Montana State has had nothing offensively in the second half. 24% from the field since the break, 0-6 from downtown. McMillan at the top, slings it over to the right wing. Chance for Grand Canyon to get a two-possession lead for just the second time today. Up to the top, Blackshire dribbles to the left wing. Slings out to the right wing, here's a three. That's no good, rebound tip, and Robert Ford wins a 50-50 ball. Hustle still there for the Cats, that's a great rebound by Robert Ford III. Montana State down 55-52. 1:45 left in the ball game. Out to Lekalat on the right wing. Hands off to Brown at the top. Curls to the elbow. Kicks to Battle. He weaves in the lane and an illegal screen and an offensive foul. Darius Brown has fouled out. Grand Canyon has another opportunity to make this a two-possession game. Montana State, one of their last seven from the field, and they haven't scored in over 3 minutes. Who's gonna bring the rain to this drought? Grand Canyon basketball going from right to left. Let's go Lopes echoing through the arena. Blackshire out to the left wing. Hands it off. Bauman takes it to the top. He gives it off to Harrison, still beyond the arc, as Grand Canyon runs their action with 15 seconds on the shot clock. Blackshear doubled, bumps, no call. Still with a bounce and 10 to shoot. Blackshear weaves inside, had it tripped, it's out of bounds, catch basketball. Jabril Bello with the active hand, knocking it away and forcing the turnover. What a job by Jabril Bello to take it away from the point guard. 55-52. Grand Canyon in front. Montana State with a basketball. 69 seconds to go in the ballgame. Ford across the half court line, guarded tightly by Blackshear. Comes right to the top. Out to the right corner, he threw it away. Out of the reach of Raekwon Battle. A turnover by Montana State. Just the 11th turnover of the day by Montana State. They really have controlled the ball well. And now a tough spot to inbound here, down to the right sideline. 1 minute remaining, Cats down 55-52. Gotta have a stop here. Blackshear's gonna burn this clock down. Takes it across the timeline. Standing dribble is Ford, prowls closely, but lets him burn this clock down a bit. Montana State has to have the stop. They played great defense in the first half. Can they bring it back to life here? Blackshear at the top, on the drive, going to the rack, the lefty layup, that's no good. Fight for the rebound, it is. Out of bounds, Grand Canyon basketball on the fight for the rebound with 36 seconds left. They've got 20 seconds on the shot clock. They're wondering, the Bobcat bench is wondering if that ball hit the rim, and the officials are not going to take a look at it.
Come on, those fans!
So they've got 20 seconds on the shot clock. Now the officials are coming together. Will they review this? Did that layup hit the rim? It was hard to see from here. Obviously, if it didn't hit the rim, then you shouldn't review, or it shouldn't have reset as far as it did. Let's see what we got. And now the officials discussing things, and they will review it. This is a huge call. Not sure what the shot clock was at when they laid it up. I mean, it was definitely under 20. I'm just not sure how low it was. I think it was into single digits on that drive by Blackshear. So did this ball hit the rim? If it did not, and then it went out of bounds, well, that's a huge call, because right now there's 36 seconds left, 20 seconds on the shot clock, Grand Canyon 55, Montana State 52. They have not been able to find the offensive life in this second half. It's really been pretty wild how much these two halves have mirrored each other, and you really don't have to look much further than just the scores. Montana State led 36-19 at half. They've been outscored 36-16 in the second half. They're down 55-52. They had a 19-point lead with 18 minutes to go, and then the offense was put on ice. Cats have turned the ball over three times in the last 4.5 minutes, and they're just one of their last seven. So the officials have finished looking at things. They're discussing things in front of the scores table, and they're saying it did hit the rim. Were they review the rim, or did they review who it went out of bounds on? I guess they're saying they reviewed who it went out of bounds on. And we'll stay with Grand Canyon. He's getting Sprinkle's getting the explanation now. So how do you want to play this with 36 seconds left and 20 seconds on the shot clock? You can play it straight up, get the stop, and you got 16 seconds to run a play. See what they do. Grand Canyon to inbound underneath their own basket. They get it in. Harrison takes it out beyond the arc, and he'll try to burn it down. Battle right up on top of his, on his hips. Takes it to the right wing, on the drive, going to the rack. The floater block. Jabril Bello knocks it out of bounds with 11 seconds on the shot clock. Another block for Jabril Bello, his second of the day. 26 seconds left. Montana State down three. Grand Canyon with a basketball on their own offensive end. They will inbound from underneath their own cup. 11 seconds on the shot clock. Out to Bauman. Tossed into the right corner. Here's a three. That's good. That might be the dagger. Javon Blackshear, the preseason player of the year, putting it home from the right corner. 23 seconds left in this ball game. Shot clock off, and Grand Canyon has come back from a 19-point deficit. They take a 58-52 lead, and we got a Grand Canyon timeout. Javon Blackshear, fourth-year junior out of Oakland, California, the leader of this team, one of the three starters coming back this year, has had a massive second half, given 16 points, and the dagger three with with Montana State now down 58-52 with 23 seconds left. They're going to need a miracle here. They should have never been in that position in the first place, but they just could not figure out how to get that offense on a roll in the second half. And I mean, what a big shot by Javon Blackshear from that corner spot. You know, at the end, things are going to go in half and half. Could go either way, but Montana State, again, they just not enough, are not having enough on the offensive end, and they've given up 39 points in the second half. It's not like they've turned the ball over a ton. Pretty even in terms of the shots taken in the second half. 29 shots taken in the second half for Grand Canyon, 25 for Montana State. The Come On In Hotel and Suites is a proud sponsor of MSU Athletics and the Montana State Alumni Association. The Come On In allows you to escape the ordinary while enjoying their numerous hotel and guest room amenities. Visit comeonin.com to book your stay today. Montana State today, 10 assists on 20 field goals. All assists presented by Aware Mental Health Services. And the Cats, 3-for-11 from the three-point line. All their threes presented by Wendy's. And 9-of-16 from the free throw line. That's a number that's going to stink for the Cats. So it was a timeout called by Grand Canyon. And Montana State will have to go the length of the floor here. Part of the reason you call that timeout, well, is to design this play here. With 23 seconds left, shot clock off, Cats need six. They're down 58-52. Inbound to Lekalad, back to Ford. He takes it across the half-court line, throws into the right corner. Patterson puts up the three. That's short. Battle the rebound. We got a foul on the floor, and it is called. Who was it? That was a massive body. Raekwon Battle touched the sky going after that. Okay, so it's called on Cabe McLaughlin going after the rebound. So Montana State will go to the line for a 1-1. Yeah, that's their ninth foul. So 1-1 here for Montana State with 17 seconds left. Down 58-52. 7-0 run down the stretch here by Grand Canyon. Cats one of their last eight from the field. Battle to the bench. Lekalad to the line. Gotta have it. Sprinkle's going to call a timeout here. First free throw is good for Patrick McMahon, who's had a nice night.
Timeout called by the Bobcats.
He's got five. Timeout called by Montana State. 17 seconds left in the ballgame. Montana State down 58-53. And they've got one more free throw coming from Patrick McMahon here. Not only is dairy delicious, but it also promotes health as well. Just three servings of dairy a day improves overall wellness and may reduce the risk of developing some chronic diseases. It's a quick, convenient, and economic way to make sure you are staying strong and healthy on and off the field. Cats letting this one get away from them. Did enough early, but just didn't have enough consistency on the offensive end of the second half. On top of that, Grant Canyon shot 59%. In the second half of this game. And as well as they played defensively in the first half, they did not have it in the second half. Montana State going to the line. Sam Lekalot heading there. Lekalot with 5 points today. Are they going to play it? Shot clock dart, 17 seconds left, down five. Free throw is up and good. So Lekalot hits them both, give him six today. Montana State down four, inbounds pass, knocked out of bounds, and they called the foul. Oh, Ford almost got it. What an effort by Robert Ford III, reaching in, almost knocked that away and stole it away. Instead, it's a foul on Robert Ford III, his fourth foul. Grand Canyon going to the line, leading by four, 16 seconds left in the game.
Blackshear
to the line. He had the dagger three that made it a two-possession game. Grand Canyon's largest lead was the six-point advantage after that three with fewer than 30 seconds left. So Blackshear to the stripe. 74% from the free throw line, and that shot is good. 17 points for Blackshear, who's gotten away from the Cats in the second half. 11 of his 17 since the break. Battle in, Bellow to the bench. Montana State down five with 16 seconds left. Can Montana State find a miracle here after giving up that big 19-point lead? The free throw is good. Fletcher hits them both. He's got 18. Montana State goes the length of the floor with 15 seconds left. Forward into the front court, out to the right wing. Down by six. Give it a battle. Tries the right wing three. Contested. That's no good. Rebound tip. Loose. It is out of bounds. Grand Canyon ball. That's going to do it. 7 seconds left. Montana State cannot hang on the second half. 60-54. Grand Canyon with the ball. They will inbound. They'd have to have a pretty miraculous steal at the end of this ball game here. Officials discussing some things here. They've looked like they are in their season opener as well. Fans jingling their keys, trying to tell the Cats to warm up the bus. Now what do we got? The officials going back to the monitor. This one's going to sting. Montana State opened up a 19-point lead, but have shot just 6 of 27 in the second half as the Let's Go Lopes chant starts up again. And this is a great team in Grand Canyon.
All year long, Lopes fans.
But Montana State was rolling in that first half. Not so much here in the second, and down 60-54 with just under 7 seconds left. So it looks like they went from 6.2 to 6.8. And we'll see what they officially put up here.
Upon further review, that call has been confirmed. So
did confirm the call on that ball going out of bounds, and they've put 7 seconds on the clock. 60-54 Grand Canyon. Canyon ready to inbound. They're going to try to go the length of the floor. Montana State's got to have a steal here. They're down two possessions, so they need something special. Here's the inbounds pass. Tossed inside. Tipped. Double team. Trap coming. Trying to get rid of it. Jump pass along the baseline. They save it, and that will do it. Grand Canyon comes back for a 19-point deficit, and Montana State has lost 60-54. That is a heartbreaking loss for the Cats. Showed they can hang, but they didn't have the consistency they needed, and the second half meltdown sends Montana State to an 0-1 start on the season. That one will sting. They just could not find the offensive touch in the second half. Montana State goes 1 of 9 from the field in the second, or down the stretch here in the second half, and Montana State has lost a very difficult ball game. We'll see how they respond. You can't really sit and wallow about it with what you have left down the stretch here if you're Montana State. You showed a lot. You showed you can hang here on the road. It's going to be a good Montana State team. They're going to have to figure something out offensively after that tough second half finish. We'll take a break. Montana State has fallen 60-54 against Grand Canyon. This is Bobcat Basketball from Learfield. Will you please give the Welcome to the Rib and Chop House post-game show. Keaton Gillogly with you as the Cats have lost today 60-54 in pretty heartbreaking fashion. At Montana's Rib and Chop House, our staff is dedicated to creating extraordinary experiences that raise the bar in each of our communities. Enjoy premium steaks, fresh seafood, and award-winning baby back ribs. We look forward to sharing a little Rocky Mountain hospitality with you. So, sour loss for Montana State. Let's see how this one went down today. And for the Cats, you know, they fell behind 4-0. So, you know, Grand Canyon scored the first 4 points of this ball game. But then they got rolling. They had a 15-0 run after that, and they were grooving and moving. Their defense was electric. They were keeping Grand Canyon on their heels. The offense was in a rhythm. They scored 36 points in that first half, and they had over 50% from the field. They weren't doing it a ton with the three-point shot. They only had three threes in that first half, and so they were balancing it around. It was really a very balanced scoring performance for Montana State in this game, but they just could not keep it going in the second half. Tyler Patterson hit a huge three at the end of the first half to beat the buzzer. They score a bucket to start the second half. They open up a 40-21 lead with 18 minutes to go in this game, and that's when Grand Canyon took over. They end up outscoring Montana State 41-18 in the second half. Montana State went 6-27 after the break, just 22%, while Grand Canyon went 59% from the field in the second half. So really tough situation there for Montana State, just unable to get it going, particularly on the offensive end in that second half. And Montana State has lost today by a final score of 60-54. So Montana State falls to 0-1. Grand Canyon improves to 1-0. You know, at the end of the year, when we get deeper into the season, you're going to look back at this game and say, well, hey, you know, a six-point loss at Grand Canyon University, that's really not the end of the world, right? That looks pretty good. If you had told Montana State that, you know, they were going to be within six, or at least Cats fans, yeah, you want to win, but that would have been okay. You would have thought, all right, we hung with one of the better teams at the mid-major level. But to have that 19-point lead and let it evaporate, that's what's going to hurt about this one. And we'll see how Montana State responds, because you're not going to have any time to feel sorry for yourself after a ball game like this, since Montana State's got a very difficult schedule coming up as we move forward. We got plenty to get to. We're going to take a break as part of this Rib and Chop House post-game show. Montana State has fallen today 60-54. We'll get back to our First Interstate Bank broadcast booth in a bit. This is Bobcat Basketball from Learfield. He will come out, yeah. Back on the Raymond Chop House post-game show, Montana State has lost today by a final score of 60-54. So tough loss for the Cats in this one, but see how they can kind of bounce back as we look forward and move forward. Bridger Brewing is home to award-winning, locally crafted beer and pizza. Bridger Brewing cheers to every adventure being better than the last. All right, let's take a look at the numbers from this ball game. It was really a tale of two halves. At the end of the game, everything looks pretty close, but it was the halftime change that really affected things. First and foremost, Montana State outscored Grand Canyon 36-19 in that second half. And Grand Canyon came back and outscored Montana State 41-18. So some big changes there at that halftime break. Individually, or as a team rather, for Montana State, they shoot 39% from the field. They go 3 of 13 from the three-point line, 23%. And 61% from the free throw line. That part is going to sting for the Cats. They go just 11 of 18 from the free throw line. Meanwhile, Grand Canyon in this game shoots 43% from the field, 6 of 21 from the three-point line, 29%, and 8 of 14 from the free throw line in this contest. Montana State as a team today had 10 assists on 20 field goals. That really slowed down in the second half today. Of course, all of our assists are presented by AWARE Mental Health Services. Cats go 3 of 13, as we mentioned, from the three-point line. All right, we are now just about ready to be joined by head coach Danny Sprinkle in this one, as Montana State falls to 0-1 on the season, while Grand Canyon improves to 1-0. And for Montana State, had that 19-point lead in the first half, but could not hold it after the break. So I'll get Sprinkle here in just a second, as the Cats have all of their games here in November but one on the road. So they have really lined up about as difficult a schedule as you can get this season. And it's going to be really tough, and Montana State's going to have to be able to find a way to bounce back and get this one going after this ball game today. But at least, at the very least, the Cats showed that they can get things going, and they can hang with some of the better mid-major programs and teams around the conference. Montana's Rib and Chop House has been serving Rocky Mountain communities for over 20 years. Our ability to grow has come through our commitment to Rocky Mountain hospitality, a concept which incorporates a casual attitude with our commitment to loyalty, safety, service, and quality food. We hope you'll be our guest at one of our Montana locations soon. So Montana State up next. We'll have Long Beach State on the road. That one's going to be a tough one as well. Then they go up to Oregon on a long road trip as well. So got a lot going on for Montana State. They won't be home until the eve of the Cat Grizz game on Friday the 18th. So that's what will be coming up next for Montana State, as they fall today 60-54 today on the road in a loud and hostile environment today. All right, we are joined now by head coach Danny Sprinkle. Coach, first half, things were rolling. What do you feel like was going right in that first half for you guys?
Yeah, you know, I mean, I thought our ball, we were finishing. You know, we did a good job. I thought our aggressiveness, I thought we were the most aggressive team in that first half. And it showed, and I thought they were the most aggressive team in the second half. They got going, you know, and a lot of it was, I mean, we had some shots right at the front of the rim, like multiple shots. You know, we gotta knock those down, because that's when they were making their run. And we missed a couple layups. And then obviously free throws, you know, and we're a good free throw shooting team, you know, but for us to miss, what, 7 or 8, and then I think there's 2 or 3 front ends of one-on-ones. And so, you know, but they, you know, they came out and earned it in the second half. You know, they drove us to the rim pretty good, and we didn't do a good job withstanding that. And it was kind of I knew we had to dominate the boards to have a chance to win. And we did that in the first half, and then the second half we got dominated on the boards. We gave up 7 offensive rebounds. And I think they were +9 in the second half just rebounding. And so it's a really good team. You know, we'll learn from it. And, you know, I'm proud of our guys' effort. You know, I mean, that's a unbelievable environment.
Yeah.
I mean, that this place was rocking. And I didn't think we got rattled. I thought we were very, very poised. And we got shots we wanted. They just didn't fall.
So on the offensive end, then, you feel like you guys were you running the right plays, making the right decisions, but they just weren't quite finishing?
Yeah, you know, because, I mean, we missed probably 10 layups in the second half. And it wasn't like they were wide-open layups, but they were looks that we got to make at least five of them, you know. And then, you know, to stymie a couple of their runs, you know, you got to knock down some free throws. Or, you know, we had some open looks from three, you know, with our shooters. You know, they got to knock those down, which they will. And, you know, but you got to give them credit. You know, the crowd got them going. And, you know, and you know, there was probably a 5-6 minute stretch where we couldn't get a stop. We couldn't stop them. And, you know, but that's why they're picked to win the WAC, too. You know, I mean, they have a lot of pride playing at home. And they got some really good players, some damn good players. You know, I mean, Blackshear, they're so quick, they're guards that, you know, they're hard to keep in front.
In that first half on the defensive end, what'd you see from your squad? It looked like you guys were really bringing it to them on that end of the floor.
On the defensive end?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, we were doing a good job. Like, we were finishing plays with rebounds. You know, like, we were being physical. We were being aggressive. And then the second half, like, they just, you know, they just kind of bum-rushed into the offensive glass. And I don't think we're as physical. And there was a couple loose balls that, you know, that they got, they came up with, you know. And we have to come up with those on the road. You can't, you know, it's a you know, a two-possession game, one-possession game. You know, those little things add up. You know, even some of our ticky-tack fouls in the second half. And then we'd have a dumb foul, and all of a sudden they're shooting two free throws in the second half when he got into the bonus. And so it's a lot of learning stuff. You know, but like I said, I'm proud of our guys' effort, and we'll get better from it.
Looking forward to it. You got a heck of a schedule coming up. Coach, appreciate the time, and we'll talk again soon for that Long Beach State game.
You got it. Thank you.
All right. Head coach Danny Sprinkle joining us post-game today as the Cats have fallen 60-54. We'll take a break. This is Bobcat Basketball from Learfield. State Bank highlights of the game. Again, Montana State falls today 60-54 against Grand Canyon. This is Bobcat Basketball from Learfield. Chop House post-game show, Montana State today falling 60-54. Up next, we have our first Security Bank highlights of the game. Let's hear how those sounded. So that was your first Interstate, first Security Bank highlights of the ball game as Montana State today has lost a lot of those highlights from the first half. That's when they were rolling, but couldn't keep it going in the second, and Montana State falls 60-54. We'll be back with more of the Raven Chop House postgame show after this. This is Bobcat Basketball from Learfield. Beautiful. Beck, one final time on the Ribbon Chop House post-game show. Keaton Gillogly with you from the First Interstate Bank broadcast position. Pleasure to have you with us this evening as Montana State has fallen today. It was a close, tight game, but they lose in this contest by a final score of 60-54. All right, let's take a look at our First Interstate Bank scoreboard today. Eastern Washington trailing Santa Clara right now, 59-51. Weber State in front of Washington midway through the first half. They're up 22-16. Finals today, Idaho State falls at BYU, 60-56. Number three, Houston beats Northern Colorado, 83-36. Michigan State beats Northern Arizona, 73-55. And Idaho falls to Denver, 68-63. Taking a look ahead at the next game against Long Beach State, presented by Vance Thompson Vision, the official LASIK and cataract surgeon of the Montana State Bobcats. That's coming up on Sunday at Long Beach State at 5 o'clock Mountain Time. We'll be on the air at 4:30 p.m. Right now, Long Beach State is leading CBU Cal Baptist 71-62 with about 4 minutes left in the second half. Long Beach State is good, man. They won the Big West last year. They went 20-13, 12-3 overall. So they're a good team, and it's going to be a tough matchup for Montana State on the road at Long Beach State coming up on Sunday. And then after that, it's up at Oregon. All right, that will do it. That'll wrap everything up for us from Phoenix. Flying back tomorrow morning, and as we look ahead, we'll get the podcast recorded tomorrow. And then we've got Cat Chat on Wednesday, the Bobcat Insider TV show on Thursday, and then football is at Cal Poly on Saturday. That's a 5 o'clock kickoff for that. And then a couple of big games coming up as well on the women's side. They've got Arizona State and BYU coming up on the schedule. Also, we'll talk with Daniel Sally, the voice for Women's Hoops here on the podcast coming up this week. All right, a couple of thank yous. First to our man John O'Connor as our producer back in the network studios. Appreciate the time both before and after the game from Danny Sprinkle as well. This is Keaton Gillogly saying so long from Grand Canyon University. Pleasure to be with you today, and looking forward to talking to you again for Hoops next Sunday for the 5 o'clock tip-off between Montana State and Long Beach State. Final score for a final time today. Montana State has fallen against Grand Canyon 60-54. We will talk to you again next week, and until then, go Cats go. This is Bobcat Basketball from Learfield.